Should I proceed with the next question? Type in yes or no, all of you. Okay. Now let's do this question. Achha, by the way, the unit for magnetic field is Tesla, which we know already, right? There is a CGS unit also. CGS unit of magnetic field is Gauss. Or just G. So remember this thing that one Gauss, that is one G, is 10 raised to the power minus 4 Tesla. This conversion you should remember, because at times magnetic field is given in terms of Gauss G. Okay. Right. Let us proceed. Next question is this. A short bar magnet. There is a bar magnet. It is placed with its axis 30 degrees with an external magnetic field. This 30 degree of the bar magnet is with the magnetic field of 800 Gauss. Okay, it experiences a torque of 0.016 newton meter. Okay, you need to find out what is the magnetic moment of the needle. That is part A. What is the magnetic moment of the needle? Second part, start doing the first part, okay? You guys start doing this part, find the magnetic moment. Once you get it, please type in the answer in the chat box. M is 0.4. I hope all of you got it. This is 0.4. How you get this answer? Torque is MB sine theta. Okay, so torque is given 0.016. This is equal to M into 800 G, which is 800 into 10 to the power minus 4 into sine theta. Theta is 30 degrees, so sine theta is half. So once you solve it, you'll get the value of M to be equal to 0.4. Fine. This is how you do the part A. In part B, you need to find how much work needs to be done to move this magnet from most stable position to the most unstable position. Acha, do you need to do positive work or negative work? You are, you know, increasing the energy of the system, because the unstable position will have more energy, right? So you are going from the most stable configuration, which will of course have lesser energy, to the most unstable position, which of course has higher energy. So when you go from lower energy level to higher energy level, you have to do a positive work, right? So there has to be a positive work. Now, how much that should be? For that, whenever you have to find out work and there are energies involved, always use work energy theorem, which is simple. You know, we have done this many a times. Work done is equal to U2 plus K2 minus U1 plus K1. Okay, so I can ignore the kinetic energy. I'll say that it is slowly moved and kinetic energy initially and finally are zero. This is U2 minus U1. Okay, and what is potential energy? Minus M dot B. That is equal to minus of MB cos theta. In a stable configuration, potential energy for stable configuration is when theta is zero. So this is minus m into b. And for unstable, you'll have potential energy mb cos 180 degree, which is minus mb into minus 1. So that is m into b. So u2 is unstable. So this is m into b minus of minus m into b. So the answer should be 2 times m into b. So when you substitute the value, you will get 0.064. This many joules of work done. Okay. Now, can you find out how much current should be there in a solenoid having 1000 turns that has same magnetic dipole moment? So magnetic dipole moment of a solenoid is NIA. Okay, this should be equal to M. So current is M, which we have already got as 0.4. divided by number of turns, which is 1000, area, which is 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 4. This you'll get as 2 ampere. Fine. So I hope you are able to solve these kind of questions. Any doubt till now? Feel free to ask anything. Fine, let us take another question. You need to find the magnitude of equatorial and axial magnetic field. How much they will be? Okay, due to a bar magnet, which has length 5 centimeter at a distance 50 centimeter from the center of the bar magnet. Okay, the magnetic moment of the bar magnet is given as 0.4 ampere meter square. So you need to find out what is B axial and B equatorial. So BE and BA. Anyone got the answer? Please message. The formula for axial magnetic field is mu naught by 4 pi to m by r cube. It doesn't depend on length, right? We are ignoring length compared to the distance where we are finding the magnetic field. Whereas equatorial is this. Correct, Saimir. So when you substitute all the values, mu naught by 4 pi is 10 raised to the power minus 7. This into 2 into magnetic moment, which is 0.4. This divided by 0.5 into 0.5. Fine. So you will get this as 6.4 into 10 raised to power minus 7 Tesla. Okay. Equatorial will be what? Negative of 3.2 into 10 raised to power minus 7 Tesla. It is half of it. Fine. So like this, you can do these simple straightforward ones. Okay, so this is about the bar magnet. Okay, now we are going to discuss something which is related to the material of the magnet. Okay, so we'll take 10 minutes break and we will meet after 10 minutes. Okay.